What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Now, this is going to be part two. I think it's part two. It looks like I broke up the first part into two parts, and this could be part three. But I think this is part two of my basement framing. Other side of the basement back there, this is the steps right here and all over here. I framed all that out on my part one series of how to frame a basement. This is part two. Now, I think I've done the hardest part already. The other side of the basement has a lot of nooks and crannies and zigs and zags. So I feel good about having that part of the basement done. But today we've got to frame out all of this area here. We're going to frame out what's going to be what I call the IT cabinet or this. I'm going to have a wall that comes off this door opening here. We'll have a door here eventually. I'm going to frame that back off over here. And you see I got my HVAC all done for the bathroom here. Back over here where the drum set kind of is now, from like just beyond this light, this is all going to be framed off here. This will be storage back here. So I got to do a wall this way, then a wall just down that wall. And we should be almost done framing. First things first, let's get cranking on this cabinet. Now what I'm going to do is, just to help you guys visualize, is I'm just going to 2x4 off and frame out. I'll put a cross brace along there. Again, I'll show you that. But 2x4, build the wall out. So you come over here, build the wall out like this, okay? It'll marry up to this up here, come down, and it'll be flush with the front of this for now. Eventually, this will all have to be boxed out for the bulkhead there. We're gonna have 2x4 wall going down this way. And then you can see over here, I'm gonna have to do a bulkhead. So I think, given all these wires are here, I'm just gonna keep running the bulkhead from all the way from that side all the way up to where I'm putting this wall right here. So again, I'll try to explain some of this as I go. Let's put you guys down. Let's get cranking. All right, so the first thing I want to do is make sure that I build this square, okay? So coming off of this, I could kind of eyeball this, but I want to make sure I get a perfect 90 off of this. So when I'm coming this way down the support beam here, I have a perfect 90. So what we're going to do is we're going to get our laser. We're going to line our laser up with the bulkhead, or the support beam rather, here. Then I'm going to get my T-square off of that line, and I'm going to draw a perfect 90-degree angle so that we know we're true off of this wall, right? Let me show you that. All right, so our laser level is all set up, and I already have it kind of triangulated right now, if you will. So you'll see at the top here, I have the beam right on the edge of this, the laser beam right on the edge of the support beam, okay? What I've done is, it's a good laser, right? It goes like 50 feet. It goes all the way down here, okay? And what you guys can do is, you can take advantage of this for two things. See how it's right again on the edge right here, okay? So right on the edge. What I'm gonna do right now is, because I know I'm gonna build a wall the whole way down the support beam, I'm just gonna get my pencil right now, and all along this line, I'm gonna draw markers. Because then I know that when I go to frame out this portion down here, my 2x4s are gonna be level and square with that beam and where they come down on the floor here, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna mark that off. And what we're gonna do right here, okay, like I said, you wanna make sure you're building this support wall here at a true, right? At a true 90 off of the wall you're gonna build on the support beam here, okay? So what I do is I have my T-square right here, okay? And you guys, we can just do a perfect 90 degree, which is not how I have that right now, but a perfect 90 degree off that beam. Okay, and then start making marks again with your pencil along that wall, and then take your laser and straighten that out, right? So let me go ahead and mark off the floor down here, then we're gonna 90 off that wall right there, and then we should be able to start cranking and cutting down some 2x4s. So you guys just saw, I went down and I marked just a quick little pencil mark on the concrete with the laser level going down that way. Now again, I wanna draw just a 90 degree off of this wall, off of this laser level line going that way. All right, and then once I get that 90 degree angle in, we just draw a straight line to that 2x4 and we should be in good shape, okay? Again, you just wanna get your T-square on the right and the level here. There is your 90 degree line coming off the laser there. We're just connect that to the 2x4 wall there. Now, it might not, when you draw that straight across, it might not line up perfectly. That's okay, you know it's a true 90 degree now. So just take your, I've got like a 3-foot level over there, my straight edge. You're just gonna scoot it until it catches on to the wall there, all right? One way is to use just my 3-foot level I have here. It's my straight edge. I can just come over here. I can line it up with my 90 degree line. Okay, and I can draw a straight line, and I can just scoot that line back till I get it where I want it, okay? Alternatively, and probably the easiest thing to do, is use my laser. Make sure the distance between this The laser line and my 90-degree line that I drew by pencil is the same, right? So it's about 2 inches, and I can come back and measure that. So here you've got, yeah, it's exactly 2 inches there. It's exactly 2 inches there. So I know my laser line is parallel to my pencil line right here. Now I can just draw a straight line across, and I've got my perfect 90-degree angle. Before I do anything, I'm going to put this whole back wall in here. It's pretty straightforward. It's just a regular wall. You can go back to part one for how to do that. I'm also going to put that wall back there in. Once these two are done, I think I'm actually going to build out this bulkhead here. The reason being that bulkhead is going to run into my IT cabinet right here. So from inside, like this will be the I'm in the bathroom right now, right? But I'm going to run this bulkhead all the way, and it's going to go into the IT cabinet here, all the way up to where I'm going to build the wall over here. And I kind of want to have some of these anchor walls in place to screw in some of my dividing walls. So I am going to put a wall right here, all right, to box in the IT cabinet. But this vent needs to be in the bathroom. So I'm going to have to put some support beams going across here. I'll do that real quick. Build a wall here. But first things first, I'm going to put this wall in first. So I have that to anchor this wall into. I need that wall done so I can anchor in my bulkhead. And then I'll do the bulkhead. So order of operation, I think, is one, that wall, two, bulkhead three, and then we're going to come back, and I think four and five is this wall to box in this IT cabinet side, and then that wall, and I'm actually going to frame in the roughing for the door today straight away as opposed to coming back and cutting it in later. I just want to start getting some of this stuff done, all right? So here we go. So we're making some progress here. It's kind of like edging in when you're painting. I'm getting kind of all like the basic things done first. So you guys probably saw on the time lapse there, I put my laser level on the bottom of these 2x4s here to make sure that, you know, while most of the time your foundation walls are pretty square, they're never perfect. So I used a laser and I just drew some lines up on the studs, the rafters going this way, just to mark where my 2x4s needed to be so that when I put my 2x4s upright, they're parallel. They're not like this. They're not like this. Okay. So you can kind of see in some of the gaps here, 2x4s are off the insulation a bit in spots. Okay. That's intentional because the foundation wall was not perfectly true. So I would try to get that as straight as possible. I also cut in my brace for up there for this wall that'll be going here. I put two braces in there for this wall just so it has a bit more support. Both of these will be anchored into the I-beam here, as well as this one will be anchored into the bulkhead when it's coming across. One last thing quickly is I'm going to actually stick frame all of this, which is a huge pain in the butt, in my opinion. I would much rather build it on the floor, hit it with the nail gun, tip it up. But with all that's going on with this post here and this post here, I think I'm just going to go ahead and just stick frame my 2x4s in. You know, it'll take an extra 10 minutes, but whatever, all right? So let's get you, let me put you guys down. Let's get cranking on this long wall right here. All right, so I've reached a good stopping point for a quick update. Unfortunately, yeah, you never have the same size stud no matter how true the house is built. So all of these studs, I kind of had to, there were some that were the same length, but all of them I kind of had to measure individually. So it took a bit longer than I wanted it to. But I don't want to have like a sloppy wall. I don't want to use a ton of space or so. I feel good about it. It looks good. So right now, everything's just kind of laid out. Nothing's like framed in or screwed in. The bottom 2x4 pressure treated plates are not anchored to the concrete yet. I'll do that here in a minute. None of these are screwed in other than the I have a screw holding in the top 2x4s, obviously. All right. So it looks pretty good. All the studs are within like a half millimeter of being actually perfect. So I only have to use probably like one or two spacers on a couple of them. So I'm not really worried about that. Again, not load bearing. Okay. All right, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to screw in the 2x4s. Okay. So because these are just kind of sitting here right now, you do want to make sure that you get your level. Okay. And you want to make sure that the wall is level. So this one's perfect. I marked off my 16 inches on square on the top and bottom plate. So I just always like to double check level before I anchor these in. Okay. And I'm not going to rehash everything again that I did in the first video. We are going to toenail all these in because I had to build it in place. So remember, I'm going to do two on one side at an angle like this, and then one on the other side, okay, into the bottom 2x4. So again, not going to go crazy. Three, the top and the bottom. It's kind of a pain in the butt. It's a lot slower than just using the nail gun and sitting up the wall, but this is kind of what I had to do given the dynamics of my basement. These posts, etc. I couldn't have leaned up the wall. It would have been, I think, actually impossible. So that being said, I want to get this wall done. Let me put you guys down. Let's hammer this out. The wall is all done. One thing that I forgot about when I started doing the basement today is don't forget, guys, your pressure treated 2x4s, probably because of, like, the water going into them or like the chemicals to treat them, rather, they're like a quarter to like a half inch longer than your standard unpressure treated 2x4s. So you're gonna have to cut off like 3/8 of an inch so that they're the same length on the top beam and the bottom beam. Fortunately, I caught that before I started screwing anything down, so no harm, no foul. All right, this wall is all done. I've anchored it to the ceiling. I've blasted it into the concrete. I have checked level. It is done. So the next thing we have to do is that we're going to do this wall here. I'm not going to get that on camera. You guys, you can watch part one. You can watch what I've been doing throughout all of the series. Hopefully by now you know how to measure out a wall. But again, I'm just going to kind of go like this and then down and then flat at the bottom of that beam. Because again, it's going to wind up teeing into the bulkhead that's going to run the entire distance of this bathroom room here again. So I'm gonna get that wall done. I'll come back once it's all said and done. All right, I lied. Just real quick, I thought I ought to show you guys how to do this true with the laser again. So I've set my laser on the floor now. By the way, these lasers are like threaded to go on like any regular stand. I could actually thread it on my camera stand there, but the floor is good enough for what I'm doing here. So I put it on the ground. You can see here now, it's drawn a line up on the rafters there. The whole length of where my bulkhead inside the bathroom here needs to be to kind of cover these wires and obviously the HVAC piping there. Now, why that's important is because you want to, where the green lines hitting all the studs, I've got my pencil now and I kind of marked off along there. So I know that this is now perfectly true, okay, next to the I-beam here, the support beam. So when I build my bulkhead brace out, it'd be right in front of this ducting, okay? The other thing that you want to keep in mind, so how do I know that it's true right now? Well, I got my tape measure, and I measured way down here where the beam was off of the support beam there, okay? So it was about 8.5 inches there, and then I walked all the way down here, okay, on my ladder, and same thing. I measured off the front, the face of the support beam, to where the beam hit on my tape measure there, and I did it until both sides were exactly even at 8.5 inches while leaving enough space for my bulkhead. So the laser level just makes everything so much easier. You know, I was able to get it true. And like I said, it took me 30 seconds to get my pencil and mark every single stud. So I know that the entire length of my ball kit now is going to be true. Now this is why this is really helpful for this wall right here. And again, I'm not going to build a wall on camera, but now I know where the front of my 2x4 has to come down because the bulkhead's going to screw into the front of the 2x4 when it goes under like this, okay? So it'll make more sense when I get the wall done. But now that I hopefully have explained that articulately enough, let me get cranking on this wall over here. All right, so just a quick check-in. I actually have to stop for the night. It's not the end of the video, but I realized I don't have the wood that I need cut for the bulkhead right here. So I have to go back to Home Depot and get some wood cut there. It'll be easier than me cutting it, but you can see this wall is all in now. It's anchored to the floor. It's anchored to the ceiling. I made some cross members up there to kind of screw into, and I hit it with a nail gun on the floor and then tipped it up. So you can see here. Now this wall is actually going to be part of like a storage room, so it's not perfect. I really don't care. I mean, I could have put a 2x4 there, or a jack stud rather. But it's just not worth it to me. So, all right, guys, well, my OCD did get the best of me. I went back and I put a jack stud the way it's supposed to be. So just remember, even if you mess up, it's wood. You can go back and fix it pretty easily. Now it's time for the bulkhead. You can see that line up there. So there'll be a flat piece of wood that comes down and rests on top of this. And it'll go the whole way down. Okay. So, unfortunately not very much done today. I actually thought I would get a lot more done. But look, it's good that we've measured everything with the IT cabinet. I know where the walls are going for the bathroom. All of my floor is all marked. The studs up top are all marked for the bulkhead. So that's all done. The leveling, the you know, making sure things are done at 90 degrees and true. It's all done. Okay, so this big wall is all done. That wall is all done. I will pick this back up tomorrow after I get some more wood for the bulkhead. I'll see you then. All right, I'm back. I went to Home Depot. I did pick up the wood that I needed for the bulkhead. Now you'll see here, like I showed you in the first video, if you haven't watched the framing part one, go check that out. But this makes doing a bulkhead really easy. You can see I have about 3 inches of space there, 3 inches of overhang here. They will marry up. You put screws in and it connects it really easy. All right, again, just cause I'm a visual person, just to help you visualize what this will look like when it's up in the rafters. This will be facing out to the, your drywall is going to screw into this. These will marry up to one another very easily. Put a couple screws through that. This is going to be rock solid. All right, so I marked the rafters earlier with the laser, as you saw. I also just now measured and I put a, I started a screw in the wood here, just one. So when I get it up there, I can hit it with one hand. Once one screws in, it makes life a lot easier. All right, once one screws in, it's rock solid. Banging the rest of them. All right, so two of the three sections are done. You can check it out here. Sorry about the lighting, by the way. I don't have any shop lights, but you can see here, even where they seam together, it's a nice smooth seam. So this makes doing bulkheads very easy and very cheap. All right, now before I add the last section of the bulkhead, which will be kind of coming off, coming down here, before I add that last section, I want to build this wall because the bulkhead's going to ultimately bump into that section. So let's build that wall and put in the last section of the bulkhead. We'll be right back. this wall is all finished. The only thing I have left to do is anchor it to the concrete. I will get to that here in a minute after I do this. So I went ahead and I mocked up a door frame on my floor just so you guys can visualize. Now, there are various standards in terms of widths. I'm doing 30-inch doors in my basement. So the standard framing for that, the roughing, is actually 32 inches wide by 82.5 inches tall. And again, there's various ways to do this, but I went ahead and just cut this so you guys can see the mock-up. I'm going to assemble this largely on the floor, and then I'm going to throw it over here in front of the IT cabinet, where it'll be anchored down to these points here on the floor. But I'm excited, guys. We're making some progress here, but let me keep going. All right, so I just had this mocked up in place right now. Nothing's screwed in, nothing's bolted down. But what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna put up one of the cross members, screw it to the bottom of this. So I already nailed that from the top. One cross member, I'm gonna nail that up, put it in the next cross member, nail them together, and then start screwing all of this together on this side, so on and so forth. So, it'll be our first doorway done here in the basement pretty soon, and I have my helpers here right now. I'm talking to the camera, buddy. These are my helpers over here. There's Landon, and there's Fager, and here's Ainsley. What are you doing? First door frame is 95% done. So I've gotten everything kind of plumbed in. Looks nice. The only thing I have left to do is I need to anchor this cross member here to this board. And then I have to go up here. I have to anchor these two together, but I'm gonna do that here off camera. But you know, look, I was picking a gamble by measuring ahead of time and like pre-framing this on the floor, but I checked level. I checked true, and it all worked out. So, hey, not bad. First door I've ever framed before. I got about 20 more walls to get done today, so let's keep cranking. All right, new day, and I'm stuck. I'm having a hard time figuring out where I want to put the door for the bathroom area. So, again, the bathroom's going to be from these posts back. All right, so it's going to be kind of this area back here. We can kind of see where I've partitioned these 2x4s here. But I think I want to have the toilet be right here where the air compressor is, because behind there's going to be a wall running back here. Behind that wall is going to be my above grade pump for the toilet. And it's kind of an awkward space, guys. Like, I can't figure out like how I want the door to be the left of this pole. So you kind of open it up, but you see the toilet right away. And then the vanity will be on that wall. If I want to put the door on this side of the pole, again, the only problem is, though, when you think about how to frame out a door, I don't want to have like just the end point be where I'm anchoring the door. I want to have it be a strong kind of foothold. So I'm thinking right now for what I'm going to do for today, I'm just going to frame these walls. I'm going to put a wall here, a wall there, and a wall there. This part is going to be all unfinished back there. But I'm going to put a wall back there anyway just to have it. If I don't ever need it, I can just take it out. Similarly to what I did over here on this side of the basement. So you'll see here, the well's back there, obviously. At some point, I'm going to have to rough in and frame a door here. But for now, I couldn't figure out if I want to do a Murphy door, what kind of door I want to put there. So for now, we're going to keep it really easy because it's not going to be hard for me to go back and rough in this door, kind of cut out the bottom beam. When I decide where I'm going to put the door, what I'm going to do is I'm just not going to anchor in the concrete down here. So I'm going to frame the walls out. I'll put screws into the I-beam up here to kind of get the wall supported. I'll screw into this wall here. So it's all kind of anchored in. I'm just not going to hammer in the concrete anchors for now. That way I have some flexibility when I go back later. The other thing, just to make you aware of, I called the gas company today, but this black line here is a gas line and it runs to my hot water heater. I'll be honest, I really don't want to build a bulkhead out all the way over here. Just a ton of like just dead space right there. I don't want to lose. So I actually called the gas company today for them to come out and give me an estimate to move that line. So I think what I'd like to do is just move this line. I don't know what the code is, so I'll find out. But I want to move this line kind of closer to this, the sore line right there, just so I, when I build my bulkhead out, and that'll all be in a different video probably at this point, but I want the bulkhead to kind of come down this way, go over and then down and then over again. I don't want to have all this be unnecessary bulkhead. So a couple things I have to wait to get done today. So again, I'm just going to frame out the bathroom walls, just get them done. And then the other thing I'm going to do is I can't put this wall going across yet because of the gas line. So I'm just going to bang out this gigantic section here. That'll be probably the easiest part of my entire basement project. So without further ado, let's get cutting. All right, and of course I wanted to just to build this on the floor and tip it up, and I'm still going to do that, but I quickly measured off camera, and every single one of these distances is different. So it goes from, it gets about a half inch longer over here than it does over here. So I'm going to measure all four of these posts and individually cut them, then we're going to frame it on the floor with the air nailer, then we're going to tip it up. All right, just another little trick to help you out when you go to put these up on the wall is I actually write down the measurement. This one's just under 90 inches here, as you can see. So writing that down can be helpful when you're trying to stick frame a wall. Well, sometimes I get it perfect every time, so I'm really happy with how this turned out. Every beam was cut to the precise exact length. It worked out perfectly, nice and snug in there, not going anywhere. I have not even anchored it to the I-beam, and as we talked about, I'm not going to anchor it to the floor until I figure out where the door is going to go. Additionally, I checked level on everything. We are right in the money where we need to be. Everything came out very, very nicely with where I need it. Checking level this way. Where is it? There we go. Right where we need to be. So again, very happy with how this wall just came out. And without further ado, we're gonna bang out the rest of these walls. Here we go. And just like that, we have another wall in right here. So we've got that wall, and then the doorway for the entertainment station there. Again, guys, I have not anchored these down to the floor, okay? So what I've done is I've put four screws going down this beam here to connect that to my door frame there. I've put screws in the top, okay, going up to the I-beam. So this is all anchored to the I-beam as well. But what I did not do is I did not anchor it to the floor, okay? Again, and if you guys noticed, I actually needed to put another 2x4 right here to be 16 inches on center. Again, I did not do that because that may become a doorway one day, and I don't want to waste a 2x4 if I have to wind up putting them flush anyway, okay? So we'll say differently. I may have to wind up putting two 2x4s flush together, not with a gap right here. So it doesn't make sense for me to do that. I can toenail another 2x4 in any time, all right? So this section's coming along. The bathroom's coming along nicely.
All right, so I did want to show you the final product of both the IT and the bathroom build-out. This view right here is just the bulkhead all the way down to the end of the IT cabinet. And then right here, you can see that I chose to put the bathroom door so that you saw the vanity when walking in. I thought that was the best angle.
I'm going to go ahead and frame this wall out here. Again, it's the same thing I've already done. I'm not going to do it on camera because it's not going to be a finished room. It's not structural. You guys have seen me frame plenty of walls at this point, so I'm going to knock that out. But what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to try to knock out some of this section over here. And then, you know, once I get that side done, we'll be like 75%, maybe even 80% done the basement, albeit I still have to come back at some point and do the entire bulkhead. So that's going to take some time. But with the methods I've already shown you in part one and in the bathroom bulkhead here, it's going to be pretty easy. So I'm going to walk you guys through that. Don't worry. But let's keep cranking on this wall right here. Then we're going to go to the wall behind me. All right, so I just came up with a really good idea, or at least I think it's a good idea. So what I'm doing is you can see that I've laid out all of my boards that'll make up this entire wall right here. And because I hate to like measure and then have a pen and paper and write things down, what I've done is, and maybe this is what everybody does, but I've labeled each of my boards 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way from 1 to 30, okay? So I've labeled all of these boards 1 through 30. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to stand up here with my cell phone recording, and I'm going to measure all 30 distances the whole way down the wall because I know they're not all going to be the same. Then I can just go back, listen to the audio, write down the measurement of each board, and then cut it accordingly. So I think that's pretty cool. I think it's a good idea. I think it's going to help save some time. You guys tell me. We'll be right back. is a thing of beauty right there. One gigantic wall, all done. Could not be happier to have that whole section of wall done, a framing done. I wish I had the dividing wall between these two going across, but again, until I move this gas line right here, there's just no point in trying to frame something out and notch it out around it. So I think with that, guys, I'm going to close off this video here. I am going to actually wind up having a part three of how to frame a basement. In part three, I'm just going to finish up this little area around here pretty quick, you know, just frame out the windows, the frame it over there. But then more importantly, I think I'm going to title the part three, how to frame a bulkhead, okay? Because I'm going to knock out that entire bulkhead after that gas line is moved. So I'm looking forward to it, guys. If you like this, please like the video. Please, please subscribe. Please comment below with any questions. I'd be happy to respond. Until I see you guys again, get in the gym, take care of yourselves, and live your dream. I'll catch you next time.